Hey, what's going on, everyone? Hope y'all are doing well out there. Today, I'm bringing you guys a really cool old Stratocaster from my secret hoard of guitars I've been keeping and probably need to move on from. So I purchased this Strat a while back because it's very similar to my main guitar, which is this 59 here. As you guys probably already recognize this one, it's pretty much the best playing sounding Strat I've ever had. I really love this guitar. So I figured this one is very close in build date and serial number and everything. So I thought maybe I could make it a project as a secondary guitar, as a backup to this one. But I don't know. I'll let you guys take a look at it and see what y'all think. But I've got too many projects right now. I just picked up a couple more really cool old guitars, 60s. I've got a few amps too that I picked up. So I've got to move something. It might be this one. You guys let me know your opinion. I'll show you guys. Give me your first impression on it because this one does have some very obvious problems. But you know me, I enjoy the player grade stuff. So I'm going to show you guys the old Strat, and then I will play it through my 1959 Tweed Bassman towards the end, so you can skip ahead to that if you want. But let me show you guys this thing real quick. So this is a black Tolex Fender case. I'm guessing it could be a 64 case because Fender did this no logo case, and then later on they added a Fender logo to it. But we'll take a look inside here. You guys will see this very luxurious plush white interior, and underneath is the orange red interior that they would have used in the 60s. You can see it there on the inside of the pocket. So definitely is a 60s Fender case. And so here we have the 1959 Strat, which you guys can probably see very obvious issues going on here. And I'll give you guys some close-ups so you can check it out. I think there will be some very divisive opinions on this sunburst finish, but this is definitely a refin if you will look at the original 59, which is more of a two-tone color. In this year specifically, they used a red dye that was very UV sensitive, so it would end up disappearing and you get more of a two-tone look. This one has a very bright red thing going on. Definitely like a homemade type job. So leave a comment down below and let me know your opinion on this. My initial thought was maybe do a refin, just like a solid color, maybe black or something I thought would look kind of cool. But again, I don't know if I really want to get into that with this guitar. The plastics on this guitar, I believe, are all original. The knobs are matching. There's some old folklore on the 59s that they used some kind of plastic on the pickup covers that didn't really age like the other plastics. So I think all this plastic is original. I can say that the guard is original for sure. The knobs, switch tip, all that matches. You got your missing piece here and your crack at the neck pickup, which very indicative of these years. This has the original patent pending bridge saddles, and the bridge block is original. As you can see, there's this little ridge down here that is a sign that this is the original bridge plate. It's got a five-way switch from what I can tell. By the way, I should mention that I do want to take this guitar apart in a later video. I know that offends a lot of people, but I do have fun with it, and that's what it's about. So, I mean, this is not a mint, you know, collector grade guitar. This is more player grade, very expensive player grade. So moving on, this guitar has a very dark Brazilian rosewood fretboard, and that's just something that you don't really see nowadays except with like ebony boards. There is something to the old Brazilian rosewood that they used back in the day. It's got a certain feel. This is my favorite look on a guitar. This also has the original clay dots, as you can see, and all of them are there. But again, that's another thing, really tough to replicate the look of those. And this guitar has a lot of cool play wear up here at the top, some pick wear on these first few frets down here. It's got really nice rolled over edges and some more play wear up here. I think these may be the original frets, and so they are quite low and hard to play. And so if I were to keep this guitar, that's another thing I would have to do is refret this thing. So moving on to the headstock, if you guys will take a look here, there's no logo, interestingly enough. But if you get it in the right light, you can see where the original logo used to be. I'm not sure why that may have happened. I know in 58, there was a period where the logos were just not adhering to the headstocks, and they changed something in the formula, but this is totally flaked off. You do see around the tuner pegs that there was some different tuners on this guitar at one point. This one also had another string tree. As you can see, we've got a hole there. All right, so as we move on, you will see the tuners are replacements. These are Cluson tuners, like double line, 60s, like mid-60s replicas, but these are not original. So I've got some single line reissue tuners that I may end up replacing on here, because that would be a little bit more period correct. You'll see the back of the neck is really clean, and I think it's been oversprayed personally. I might put a black light to it to try to find out, but I think there's some overspray going on. If I were gonna keep this guitar, I would probably strip the finish off the back, because to me, honestly, there's nothing better than having the finish plate off. You'll see how dark the neck is on this one. That is pretty crazy. If it were me, I would strip this off. You're not gonna harm the value of the guitar at all. And to me, it's gonna play better, feel better. It's a nice neck, it really is. You take the paint off of here, maybe put a decal on there. This would be a great neck. Of course, I'd refret it with some jumbos. Moving on to the back here, we've got a neck plate with a serial number of 45397. Which is just about 100 digits away from my guitar. As you all know, Fender did not care about serial numbers. They just had a bin of neck plates, basically, and they would just slap them on guitars. So that's not the best way to date your guitar. I think this one is very close to mine. All the features really line up with my guitar. So the back plate here looks like some kind of homemade job. Etched their social in there and then scratched it out. And there's another look of that very unique burst. So yeah, a really neat guitar. It needs some work to be set up and playing as I would like it, but this guitar has a lot of potential. I mean, you know, if you wanted, refinish it, whatever color you desire, not gonna change the value. Some other cool things. In the case, I found this, which is the original tip to the pick guard that broke off. I don't know how this managed to make it all these years with the guitar, but it's still there. So that's kind of a cool feature if you wanted to glue it back on. It also has a certificate from Grunes Guitars with a little appraisal. Certify the guitar described below is in our opinion, blah, blah, blah. I think that's all I got to say. Like I said, let's go ahead and play it through the basement, just straight in. I'll try to do some clean tones. And then I'm gonna crank it up and do what I do with it. We'll see how it sounds. Let's check it out. Thank you. Well, I want to say thank you so much for tuning in today. All of you who subscribe, like, comment, share, everything really means a lot to me. So if you would leave a comment and let me know your opinion of this guitar. And like I said, I got a couple new guitars in right now, sitting right over there, and a couple new amps as well. So some cool stuff coming in the future. Thank you guys for tuning in. Peace.